Hello everyone, I am Sridevi from SICAB Institute of Engineering and Technology. Today we'll be looking at the contents of the web service security. We have seen the web has helped us in a lot of ways, especially in terms of the shopping, the banking, and also paying the bills, right? As it provides the services for us for 24/7, and it also helped in the supply chain management, which improves the communication. Then we have composite nature, atomic service, and also the interoperability. Interoperability, irrespective of the platforms it is being developed, the it is providing us the services. And for example, if we take that travel, if I want to travel from one city to another city, so I book the ticket using the travel agent, and this travel agent is providing us a pop-up menus where they are giving us the link to book the airline tickets and also book the hotels and the rent the car. So there is no need for us to log in into a particular website and rent it, because they are giving just the links. So this is how the web application is providing us the services at one stretch itself. Then moving on to the next one is, what are the entities involved? So the entities involved is the client, that is service requester, and the service provider is the server, and we have the database that is acting as a register or also a service broker. They have been providing the services. So the service requester first is going, when the service requester is going to send the request, first the server has to make sure he is going to register in the database. Based on the particular database available, the client is going to discover that what services are available, and later he is going to bind with these people. So the next one we are seeing, what technologies are being available so that these web services are very easily available and it is very interactive for us. So various web services are available. That is, the first one is XML, then we have SOAP, then we have WSL and UDDI. So the first we will discuss what is XML. So XML is extended markup language, which is using lot of the tags, so as it provides a proper structure for the document. So if you see any normal HTML page, it is very easily organized and very neatly organized. So this XML is going to provide them, or I can say it is going to describe the structure, how the data should be represented. So it is going to contain the elements or the sub elements, or it may have even the attributes. When I'm been talking about these attributes, it is giving us from where those values are going to start. Now this one you can see, there is an example of a chapter. If I see a book, it is neatly organized with the chapters, having the section and having the subsections, within which we are having a lot of the data, that is called as paragraph. Now you can see that when a chapter is begin, then that chapter has to be ended, so they are using a slash symbol. So when section they begin, we are going to end that section and the subsections and the paragraph. So this is the way the data is neatly arranged, and this is how it is visible for us on the web page. The next one you can see, this is an example for the purchase order, where you can see that here we have the XML version. It is shipped to, you can see there is a country and India. So the country is acting as an attribute and India is a value for that one. So under this one, we can see the name, street, city, state and PIN. So to whom it has to be shipped every time it has been printed. And you can see here in the items, what items are being there and what is the price. So what is a part number being there, and here also you can see there what is a product. So this is the way when a purchase is being done, how the items are being arranged properly. So once it is been there, we get a sheet which has been automatically computer generated, which provides us the shipping instructions from the user, to the client, from where he has to be delivered. So this is how the proper information is developed. The next one is called as a SOAP. What is it? SOAP is Simple Object Access Protocol. So it is a framework which is used for exchanging the structured information over the internet. Now this is made up of an envelope. In this envelope, it is going to include a header. This envelope is including a header and also a body. Okay, now when I'm talking about this header, it is optional. Okay, and this body is containing all the information within this one. When I'm been talking about the header, as it is optional, I've been said. So what it is including is, this is including meta information. Right, this is including meta information, such as I can say it is including the encryption algorithm, it is including the digital signature of the messages and all. Okay, now what the body is going to contain is, the body is going to contain all the remote procedure calls. So that is called as RPC, remote procedure calls, that has to be made for this documents, right? And whenever we are sending this one, so this is in the form of your HTML pages, that is in terms of your HTTP request and also in your HTTP response, right? So it is your HTTP response page. Now you can see in this one, there is a SOAP where we can see that there is a post, right? This is a posting message, that is for the request, where you have the version, you have an envelope having the body, right? You can see that body is begin and end. We are ending this envelope, and for this post request, we are getting the response in terms of the okay, right? And you can see again here also it is having the body and the response, what you have been exactly asking. So this way the format of the data is being exchanged. So actually, when on the web page you get it, just you are getting the tabs, you enter the request and you send the response, but back end, this is the process how exactly the data is exchanged. Okay, moving on to the next one is WSL and UDDI. What is that? WSL is nothing but Web Service Definition Language, which is used to define or describe the web services. Now, when I'm been saying the operations and communication protocols, they are being used to provide these web services. So, together to bring them, that is operations and communication protocols, we call them as the binding process. So this is where we are bringing together the operation and communication protocols, we refer that as binding. Okay, now what are the elements it is including? It is including the types, it is including messages, it is including operation, port types and bindings. Now let us see that what is this, what exactly is the port type. So it is going to say that the port type is going to say that what are the different operations it can perform. Then what is this operation is being saying is, what is the action to be performed. It is going to say what action has to be performed. And when I'm been saying this message is nothing but what exactly a data has to be exchange is the part of that operation. So it is going to give us, I can say a meta, or I can say the abstract definition of the data being exchanged. So this is being provided by the WSDL. Okay, the next one is UDDI. What is that? UDDI is nothing but it is a universal description, discovery and integration, which is providing as a registry or the catalog, so that they are going to be available to the people across the globe. So this UDDI is acting as the registry. If you people remember, at the beginning I had said there is a provider, there is a requester, and the third one was registry. So UDDI is used for this registry. Okay, now what it is going to do is, whenever a person is going to send a query, it is going to reply for these operations. Now here also it is going to use the operations, the messages, the protocol, so that whatever the service is being asked, it is being provided. So simple example if I have to give you is, you log in into the Amazon app, you request for a particular product where it gives you, it specifies you the range, what is the color, what are the options in that one, what is the price, what is the manufacturing date. So you get it in a very neatly arranged form. So to make that arrangement and to make the, whether the product is available in the store or it is out of the stock and all, it is available from this registry. Now what it is doing is, it is having this registry is including some of this in the form of the pages, that is called as white page, yellow page and a green page. So what this white pages is going to do is, it is going to, white page is going to provide the address and the contact information, right? Then the yellow page is going to provide, this yellow page is going to provide the industrial categorization. So what it is going to provide is industrial categorization of the services, right? And what does the green page is going to provide is, it is going to provide the information about the services, okay, of the business that is being done, okay? So this is the way the web service technologies are used, so that the information is displayed in a very neat manner. So these are the three languages or technologies they are being used, so that the data is neatly arranged, or it, you can say that it is properly structured. Hope the concepts are clear for you people. Any doubts you can ask. Thank you.